गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस स्टोरी। नाउ यू विल फाइंड द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चंस। व्हाई डज मिसेस हॉल फाइंड द साइंटिस्ट इसेंट्रिक? Second is, what curious episode occurs in the study? And third question is, what other extraordinary things happen at the end? You will find the answers of these questions in this. Eager to get away from crowded London, he took a train to the village of Iping, where he booked a room at the local inn. Now, he had no place to live. So he took a train. He means Griffin took a train and he booked two rooms at the local inn. The arrival of a stranger at an inn in winter was in any case an unusual event. It was winter season and it was an unusual, extraordinary event. A stranger of such uncommon appearance set all tongues wagging. Mrs. Hall, the landlord's lady, made every effort to be friendly. And now the appearance was very strange. The appearance was very strange, and Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, made every effort to be friendly with him. But Griffin had no desire to talk. But Griffin did not want to talk to her and told her, my reason for coming to Iping is a desire for solitude, loneliness. I do not wish to be disturbed in my work. Besides, an accident has affected my face. Now, he said that he did not want to talk to anyone and he did not want to be disturbed because he was working, and because of the accident, his face was affected. Satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist, eccentric, full of whims, and in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance, Mrs. Hall was prepared to excuse his strange habits and irritable temper. And now she became satisfied because the payment he had done. My reason for coming to Iping is a desire. Satisfied that her guest was an eccentric. But the stolen money did not last long. Lekin jo stolen money, he had stolen money, and ultimately it ended. And presently Griffin had to admit that he had no more ready guest. And now he also admitted that he had no cash now, so he pretended that he was expecting a check to arrive at any moment. At any moment, he would be able to get a check. Shortly afterwards, a curious episode occurred. Curious, strange episode occurred. Take place. Very early in the morning, a clergyman and his wife were awoken by noises in the study. At that time they were studying and they were awoken. Creeping downstairs, they heard the chink of money being taken from the clergyman's desk, and they also heard that somebody has taken the money from the clergyman's desk. Without making any noise and with a poker grasped firmly in his hand, the clergyman flung open the door. And after that, the clergyman flung his room open the door. The door was open and nobody, he was unable to see anyone. Surrender. Then, to his amazement, he realized that the room appeared to be empty. Now he became very much surprised that no one was there. The room was empty. He and his wife looked under the desk and behind the curtains and even up in the chimney. There wasn't a sign of anybody. They try to find anyone everywhere, but they are unable to find. Yet the desk had been opened and the housekeeping money was missing. The desk was open and the money was missing. Extraordinary affair, the clergyman kept saying for the rest of the day. And now he became very surprised. But it was not as extraordinary as the behavior of Mrs. Hall's furniture a little later that morning. The landlord and his wife were up very early and were surprised to see the scientist's door wide open. And now they saw that the door was open. Usually it was shut and locked, and he was furious, angry. If anyone entered his room, if anybody entered in his room at that time, she became very surprised. The opportunity seemed too good to be missed. They peeped round the door, saw nobody, and decided to investigate. The bedclothes were cold, showing that the scientist must have been for some time and a stranger. Still, the clothes and bandage that he always wore were lying the room. So, students, you are able to understand this now. Thank you.